north of the Jackson County line, the area of rotation 4 miles north of the Jackson County line, and will ultimately be moving into Jennings County within the next 12 minutes. Status update on the tornado warning north of our area. That one's north of Jennings County only, and they have, by the way, gone over to tornado confirmed. So again, I mentioned this, guys. These are not tornado possible scenarios. Some of these have confirmed tornadoes. Rock Creek right now is getting hit by a tornado in Indiana. So the National Weather Service has gone over to what we call tornado confirmed, tornado observed. A confirmed tornado was located 8 miles east of Columbus. I hope that this doesn't happen on the storm near the Jonesville area. But that said, Hannah, this is, I think, probably our fifth confirmed tornado from the National Weather Service that we have dealt with thus far today.
And that just goes to show why we're still here with you, because it just takes one scan of the radar, one update of the radar to go from we see an area of rotation that could produce a tornado to that thing now produced a tornado. It takes one scan, and that's why we're still here with you, because again, as we keep telling you, we still consider this very much to be a threat, and you can see clearly the rotation. In fact, I'll circle it here for you, just outside Jonesville. And even if you just take away the tornado threat momentarily, this is posing a pretty significant wind threat to folks driving I-65 right now. So if you even just take away that you see that rotation there, strong wind gusts are likely. In all of these storms, we have had the threat of wind gusts anywhere from 50 to 70 miles per hour. And any high profile vehicle, any driver of a high profile vehicle will tell you that's not any good. So as this cell crosses over, as this rotation crosses over I-65, not only are we concerned with the threat of this rotating cell producing a tornado, I'm also concerned with the threat of what strong wind gusts across the interstate will do. Now, as we zoom in a little bit on this area of rotation, you can see here that this couplet has come together a little bit more tightly just in the last scan. So here's the current scan. We walk it back once. Here it's a little bit more broad. As I
said, 5-2 again, which is concerning.
Right on top of 65. So the Weather Service just updating a couple of the tornado warnings that are active right now, and they've issued one much farther north.
Yeah, they issued one that's for Rush County, Indiana, not affecting our viewing area. So the area of rotation, Hannah, that we would be concerned about is going to head into the northern part of Jennings County.
Yes.
But that area of rotation right now is going along 65 just north of Jonesville, or just near the Jonesville area. That's the one that we're watching the closest as that continues off towards the east. By the way, the Weather Service noted that a confirmed tornado 8 miles east of Columbus, and what they said is that a brief tornado was reported in rural east central Bartholomew County. So that was not radar indicated. That was a spotter on the ground noting that a tornado occurred. So we continue with severe thunderstorm warnings. And so what they're doing down line here, this may be a positive here for getting back to golf. For those that are curious, again, I'm not trying to be insensitive to anybody. And I hope you know, look, today's my day off. The last thing I want to do on my day off is come into work and talk for a couple of hours. Like you, I do like to enjoy time off and rest a little. So just understand that, you know, what we're trying to do is what is our job. My station and our community ask us to help if there's possible tornadoes or if the weather can hurt me. And all, when you guys have asked us to do that, all we have done is dedicate our lives to trying to protect. So just understand that that's all we're trying to do. So Northern Jennings County, we're watching you real closely now. That's where the area of rotation is moving now. That's the area where we're most concerned about. It has passed 65. I'm glad to say that we did not see any debris lofted while it was going past 65. My hope is that it did not do any damage, but that said, it's right over Jonesville. Jonesville, you've got to be in your tornado safe locations right now. You have to be in your tornado safe location right now. And then down the line, Scipio through around Geneva and Brewersville, I need you to take your tornado safety precautions. The storm, interesting. So the storm has developed what we call a rear flank downdraft, this little area on the back edge of that storm. What that normally means is that we'll rush cold air around the southern side of the storm. So here's the reason that is important. When you get an RFD that starts to generate, you can sometimes see an enhanced area of rotation develop quickly on it. So we need to watch near Jonesville and Geneva quickly to see if that would help possibly pulse that rotation up a little bit, but that is a signal sometimes that can cause an increase of rotation. Severe thunderstorm warning remains in effect for Northern Jennings County. So even if this thing doesn't produce a tornado, You're talking about 70s in terms of wind speeds. 70 mile an hour winds are damaging winds. They're beyond damaging. So 60 is considered a damaging wind gust. A 70 is considered a destructive wind gust. That can destroy outhouses, barns, that can tear off roofs. 70 mile an hour winds can take down a lot of trees. Please take these storms seriously in the northern part of Jennings County, where my concern now is transitioning from Jackson in the next 4 minutes more towards Jennings County. But if you're in Geneva, we've got to watch that really closely. Hannah, that RFD does indeed indicate sometimes that we're going to see an enhanced area of rotation, but we should be able to see that within the next 6 minutes.
Yes, I agree. Within the next few minutes, we'll have an update to see how that influences the storm motion, the storm development. But I'll tell you again, because we've been watching severe storms through southern and central Indiana all afternoon, we saw this once before with a thunderstorm just north of this area. It did produce this rear flank downdraft, which then did lead to an increased area of rotation. So again, we're not just here wasting your time. We'd love to sit back and kick our feet up, but because these storms are still very strong, because they have a history of producing tornadoes very quickly, and because we're now seeing signals on radar that rotation could increase in the next couple of minutes, that we could get a quick spin up, we still believe that this poses a threat to the folks specifically around Do you have an update, Mark?
No, just to confirm. I agree. Okay. Jonesville, I mean, it's right over the top of Jonesville right now. I mean, if you're in Jonesville, the time to take your tornado safe precautions was 5 minutes ago. Scipio's down the line, and we need to be thinking about that now in Geneva. What are you going to do as the storm comes towards you? 17 minutes left on the tornado warning. We'll see if the Weather Service stays with the tornado warning. My sense is we should know within the next 6 minutes if it's going to be needed, because that RFD can do two things. It can cause rotation to increase briefly, and then it can also cause a weakening. You know, interestingly enough, Hannah, look at that back storm also west of Pershing, starting to have a hook on it as well. That with this boundary within our region, it is something we're going to have to watch. All of these storms, you can indeed sometimes get quick tornado warnings. What happens sometimes in this scenario is the Weather Service will transition from tornado warnings to what we call severe thunderstorm warning with tornado possible tag. And what that means is that they can produce quick tornadoes, but the threat would go more towards damaging winds. My sense would be within 17 minutes, we will see the Weather Service transition more towards severe thunderstorm warning with tornado possible tags, because the rotation remains there. But it again continues to be borderline. You can still get tornadoes quickly. You just normally are not talking about the bigger kind out of this kind of a setup.
Agreed.
Also, we've got to watch for flood concerns here. The storms continue to train over the exact same area. And I'm sure this is something you'll discuss in depth at 10, Hannah. But, you know, there are going to be parts of our area that exceed 4 inches of rain in the next 7 days. This is a setup. It's unbelievable that we're talking about it again, but this is a setup that's going to produce heavy rain in our area again.
Well, that's what you don't want. We know we're going into kind of a wet period in our forecast. We've got 5 of the next 7 days, pretty much a guaranteed rain on them, scattered showers at the very least. So we know we're going into a wet period weather-wise. What we don't want to see is that kickoff with a day like today, where some folks are seeing quick, heavy downpours that then last over their area. Folks are picking up 2-3 inches of rain from some of these cells that we've seen earlier this afternoon that has produced flash flooding concerns. So what we don't want to see is leading into a really wet pattern anyway, that we start off with a quick 1 or 2, even up to 3 inches of rain at this point. So in fact, I'll switch you over easy for sure. This rainfall rate outside Jonesville is 5 inches an hour. That's not to say that it's going to rain in Jonesville for a full hour, but think about it. If it rains for 30 minutes there, you've picked up more than 2 inches of rain. So that's what we're talking about in terms of the heavy rain threat today leading to flash flood concerns. That's a very real threat as well. Obviously, right now, the tornado potential is going to be the most life-threatening, but in the next 30 minutes to an hour, that most life-threatening concern could transition to more of a flash flood threat. So something that we're watching very closely, the threat of flash flooding. And we mentioned earlier the threat of strong wind as well. It's not just that these storms are spinning. You have to remember that the spinning motion is being caused by strong wind going one way and strong wind going the other way. So we've had reports in these thunderstorms this afternoon of gusts up to 50 miles an hour. Even some of these warnings contain language that says watch out for wind gusts up to 70 miles per hour. And that's where you start to see more of that widespread damage. So in addition to our concern, a very real concern of quick tornadoes spinning up. Mark, we just got a new tornado warning showing up on the map here. In addition to our concern about tornadoes, which is very real, we are also watching the threat of destructive wind and mm-hmm. of flash flooding.
And the new tornado warning was issued. This one's until 9:30. Tornado warning is going to be effect for Jackson and Jennings County. We're getting into that scenario where it's a line, and there could be, it's going to be very difficult to say the exact spot where a tornado would form. But here's the thing, Hannah, that Jonesville area has a tornado warning on it, and now they've issued for the back storm that you and I just talked about. Mm-hmm. That storm that's in the southern part of, or the western part of Jackson County, just got a tornado warning on it, where we're seeing rotation on that storm as well. So we've spent our time here, a lot of it on the Jackson and Jennings County, the one that's straddling that county line. But now let's talk about the storm that's a little bit further off to the west, as this one now has a new tornado warning on it. So this one is for the western part where the storm is located right now, the western part of Jackson County. See that storm right there? Remember how we talked about how it had a little bit of a hook on it? So this storm right now also showing rotation in it. As we can scope that storm, you will notice it has the greens next to the reds right here, the western part of Jackson County. And so this is going to take us through 9:30 Jennings County. This means for you, again, what we're going to do is keep the golf coverage here on the larger box for you. And we've got the severe weather coverage on one side. All we're trying to do is just cover. We also want to make sure that you guys have options here. Also note that the tornado watch has been canceled for Du Bois, for Orange, for Washington County. It's also been canceled for Scott County and canceled for Jefferson County of Indiana. Only under the tornado watch right now would be Jackson, Jennings, and Lawrence. And Jackson and Jennings County are the only two counties that remain under tornado warning. But if you're in Pershing now, you got to take your tornado safety precautions. Secondary storms moving towards you. Hannah, this may be the third area of rotation, as I'm thinking, that's gone across the Pershing area. So, you know, we talk about this sometime, but there's a term called warning fatigue.
Yes.
And what can happen is viewers sometimes, and this is real, you go under a tornado warning, you go under another, and at some point you may be like, you know, I haven't seen anything out of this one, but this is probably an hour and a half going now where we've seen a tornado warning in the northern part of Jackson County. And you've been watching rotation, debris. And there has been some subtle things that may show some damaging winds, but it's hard to say that that's for sure a tornado in anything we're looking at near Jonesville.
I agree with that. We are watching it very closely, though, and so I'm going to flip over here to the kind of debris product that I have been watching a little bit more closely. And so you can see here the little red and yellow areas. That's where maybe, possibly, but it doesn't really line up correctly with reflectivity and with velocity, which I'll come back to in a moment. Mark, though, you have that update from the Weather Service.
Yeah, we're getting reports now in the Reddington area that a funnel cloud is being reported by first responders. So in the northern part of Jackson County, first responders are indeed reporting a funnel cloud. Here's the problem, is we've been saying this, but a quick tornado could form at any time from any of these storms. Hannah continues to look for debris within the storms, but we now have two specific storms that pose a threat for us to produce possibly a tornado. There's two storms right now that are of threat. Heading towards Geneva. So this would be storm number one. The second storm right now is moving towards the Pershing area. So if you're in Scipio, if you're in Geneva, you need to take your tornado safety precautions. And then that second storm that's near the Kurtz area, we're watching closely. The rotation on this one, Hannah, I have to say that rotation may be, that's the storm right now.
That is the storm.
That storm northwest of Kurtz is a concern. That's the one with the funnel cloud.
Yes.
That may produce a tornado momentarily. That's strong rotation on that storm.
Yeah, I agree with you. So the Weather Service is updating a separate storm there. But as we watch this rotation outside Kurtz, as Mark mentioned, that is where we have a report of a funnel cloud. Here's the difference. A funnel cloud is hanging down from the parent cloud. It has not touched the ground yet. So we need, in order for that to be a tornado, it needs to lower all the way to the ground. We certainly have evidence on radar to support that that is possible. That cell is rotating. You can clearly see it with the red right next to the green. This thing is spinning. And we have now a report of a funnel coming from that general area. So this is something we're going to be watching very closely in the next couple of minutes to see how this evolves on radar, to see if we get any more reports via the National Weather Service from train spotters in the area, from emergency managers, first responders in the area. And we thank all of them for those reports while reminding all of you that it's time to be in your safe place. Now is not the time. Please hear me. Now is not the time to be outdoors trying to see if you can spot it. That is not not right. safe. We need you to be in your safe place if you're near Kurtz, if you're near Freetown. If you're in the Pershing area, this storm is headed your way and it is spinning. So we are going to take this one very seriously. You can see a new warning box, a new tornado warning issued north of our WDRB viewing area. We are going to focus though on this cell headed toward Pershing in the next few minutes. That one is spinning. We have a report of a funnel in the area, so this is the one that we have our eye on right now. And you can
see. It is crazy the amount of tornado warnings we got on a setup like today. Whew. I mean, the thing about today is, and we were talking about this on TV last night, is that you would, anywhere north of the river, you'd have a severe weather threat. And we talked about how you can get quick tornadoes in this scenario. The boundary has been incredibly impressive, and this storm is really the most concerning storm that's in our spot right now. This could produce a tornado at any moment. This has strongest rotation we've seen on our group of storms that have been in the area. And you can see it does have a little bit of a hook on the edge there. Tracking it, storms have been moving off to the east at around 30 miles an hour. Puts it in the Pershing area 9 minutes. So 9 minutes until the tornado warning, the possible tornado would be in the Pershing area. In the Spraytown area, you've got about 14 minutes from now, and then in Surprise, Indiana, 16 minutes from now. These are too close for you to wait. You need to be in your tornado safe spot now. And what that means is I need you to go downstairs. I need you to get underneath something. I need you in the center part of your house, and you need to keep away from windows. There are a number of tornado warnings that continue in central Indiana. And let me just mention again, think about the flood concern, especially in northern Jennings County. You can see excessive rain moving through. There's another tornado-worn storm. There's another one behind it. Hannah, this can in itself develop into a life-threatening flood situation. There are a number of concerns in a scenario like this. And this is going down 65. This is not a good situation where we now have another area rotation that will go down 65. And this one will, I mean, the amount of rain is incredible. I suspect we will see the flash flood warnings at some point extended into our area as well.
I firmly agree. I also want to point out, you're seeing how these tornado warnings are being extended slowly farther south. You see the lines I've drawn here showing how that progresses a little bit farther south. So believe me, we hear the folks in and around Louisville, even farther south, saying that's so far away from me. You know, why do I care? Well, we certainly care. These people are dealing with life-threatening weather, and now you see that is progressing a little bit farther south, a little bit even more into our WDRB territory. So we're going to stay with you. We're going to make sure you have the information that you need to make smart decisions while this threatening weather is in your area. So we do have, I would argue, in those areas, if we're naming towns that are near you at any point this evening, it's time to be in your safe place.
Uh-oh, there we go. New scan just came in. That one, even the rotation looks more significant. Hannah, I'm coming over to you on analyst right now.
Okay.
So on the left part of the screen there, you can see the rotation. So here's that rotation. It is very tight rotation. So let me explain what this means when you see the greens and reds. Radar actually technically cannot tell if something is rotating, but what it can do is it can tell if the winds are blowing away from the radar and towards the radar. We call that Doppler velocity, hence the reason Doppler radar. So when you see this green, it means it's moving towards the radar. When you see the red, it means it's moving away from the radar. So what happens when you have air that's moving towards and away right next to each other? It is implied motion. So when the red and the green are far apart, it's what we call diffuse or broad rotation. When the red and green are right next to each other, it's what we call tight rotation. This storm has tightened up, and on the right part of your screen, we're looking right here near the Kurtz area. If you're north of Kurtz, I want to emphasize you have got to be in your safe spot right now. There is not any confirmation of tornado right now within the debris signature or the debris detector. But at this point, that rotation is significant. Significant rotation on that storm north of Kurtz. Hannah, for our viewing area, this has been the most significant tornado threat thus far. This thing is spinning hard. It is tight gate-to-gate shear, and it very, very possibly could be or could be producing a tornado already, or may produce a tornado within the next few moments.
I wholeheartedly agree with that, and so that's why we're watching it so closely. As we keep an eye on that center of rotation, we are also watching for National Weather Service updates from the area.
And we have a tornado warning, by the way, for northern Jennings County. So northern Jennings County under a tornado warning now. This is a separate one until 9:45. I apologize for interrupting.
No need to apologize, especially when you see that couplet, that area of rotation. When we look a little bit farther to the east, we'll slide this a little bit farther, you can see just to the east of Jonesville, just outside Scipio, see that rotation, reds right next to the greens. That's what we're watching for this new tornado warning. That's where the couplet is. I would also argue
that one's going to be, if you catch a tornado, it's going to be along that line.
Right.
It could occur anywhere from Scipio. Even if you're in North Vernon, you got to take your tornado safety precaution now, because like you said, it's not as defined, but it extends over like 4 miles where you can get a quick spin up on that, and anywhere along that line.
Agreed. Well, wholeheartedly agreed. So if you're anywhere, remember, we're not just calling out specific cities. If you live in a community that's near one of these towns that we're calling out, you need to be in your safe place. As we've seen this afternoon and this evening, quick spin ups are very possible, also just very likely inside of these cells. We're still watching this area of rotation outside Kurtz. In fact, I would argue that right now is our greatest threat, greatest tornadic potential inside of these cells. In fact, I'm going to go back to that two-paneled view that we look at and put the reflectivity on one side and show you not necessarily a tail per se anymore, Mark, but we are seeing an extension from that cell.
And the tornado warnings to the north, for what it's worth, Rush County continues with tornado observed. So tornado, confirmed tornado over Rushville right now. This is not good. This one is north of our area. Damage has been reported south of the Rushville area. But again, not good situation where to our north, there are confirmed tornadoes touchdown. Freetown looked like it got hit significantly. You can see Rushville right this going through the night, but we do not have any reports of damage. But Freetown got hit hard earlier. The debris was lofted 24,000 feet up into the air. We're very concerned right now near the Kurtz area. This storm near Pershing is our storm. This is our play in Pershing right now. There could possibly be a tornado either forming, at least an area of rotation near the Bald Knobs area near Pershing. That's about to cross over Indiana 58, eventually heading towards Bobtown, Cortland, and Shields. Seymour, you need to be thinking, if this storm comes towards me, what do I do? You're under the tornado warning. I want to give you an ETA for your area. Acme, 6 minutes. Cortland, 16. Hangman Crossing, 20. 6 minutes until this storm gets to your area. Continuing to watch for any debris. Fortunately, I have not seen anything yet. Also, remember, new tornado warning here for the northern part of Jennings County. The problem with this one is it is going to be more difficult because there is a broad area that is rotating in here. And this one actually looks like that rotation area may have come up a little bit near the Geneva area as well. What could be just some debris getting lofted. Let me come over to you, what Hannah's looking at. So Hannah, what that could be is maybe from a more of a gust front. When you see these little holes like this in the pink, normally what that means is you're getting some damage from straight line winds. Traditionally, when it's a tornado, it will be very, very defined on the edges and almost circular based. But Hannah, that could be more of a signal of damaging winds along the front of that line moving towards North Vernon. So if you're in North Vernon, take that damaging wind threat a little bit higher, at least seeing some leaves that are likely being lofted within there. But that could also be more. I mean, it's at least shows us that the storm is doing. It could just be leaves, but it's lifting something up that's not rain.
I absolutely agree with that. And in fact, we're going to zoom out. I'm going to take you to that Rushville storm and show you what Mark's pointing out. You can see where we have a confirmed tornado on the ground. Again, this is not inside of our WDRB coverage area. Please understand this is for illustrative purposes, but you can see a much tighter circle in that pink product. The blue is very tight and very focused together and shows us that is much more likely tornadic debris. When we come back a little bit farther south to this storm headed towards Scipio, the debris is spread out. You see those yellow colors? It's not quite as deep of a hole and it's more spread out. So I agree wholeheartedly that I think this is much more of a straight line. It's much more likely caused by straight line wind or by some sort of gust front in that storm. So wind threat, large. in that cell headed towards Scipio. But that's not the only spot that we're watching. Still,
boy, that thing is spinning hard.
Outside Kurt, spinning like a top. That is still there. It's persisted scan after scan, and that has our attention right now as far as tornadic potential goes.
And Hannah, I'm going to put a little circle on there on the screen. Yep. Do me a favor if you could. Let's see a reflectivity here briefly so we can see what portion of the storm we're looking at. So, okay, we're waiting now for that new scan to come in. So, what you see closely, there's the new four. That's something we'll watch very closely. There's the new scan. Okay, so now our new scan shows the rotation remains tight here north of the Freetown area. Now, Hannah, let's do the same exercise. Okay, so that is buried in the storm. So now what I'd like to see is what we're looking at here on debris, anything being lofted. Okay, good to see that right now. If we were to see something that would be very concerning in that pink, you would look for basically something that would look like a blue ball in there. If we see anything that starts to turn blue in there, it will tell us tornado is occurring. We are seeing still significant rotation in this storm, and we need to watch it very closely. If you're in North Vernon right now, please stay away from any windows. A lot of lightning still on this storm as well. Very heavy rain. That one's crossing through North Vernon. And then our strongest storm right now for tornado potential is going to go right down Indiana 258, which is east-west. So that is going to make its move towards around the Seymour area and Reading. Lines of storms continue in this area, which opens the door for other potential. Watch motion here over the last 3 hours, and you can see we're setting up what we call training. Training is when storms move over the exact same area. The concept here is if you're on train tracks, the storms would basically be held along those train tracks. And when that happens, you can get a significant threat of flash flooding. And that is lining itself up in the northern part of Lawrence and specifically really northern Jackson and Jennings County, where we have multiple threats here. Tornado warnings remain in effect. Also possibility of damaging winds continue to occur. The areas of greatest concern within these would be for the tornado potential Pershing just along Indiana 258. So along Indiana 258, Spraytown, Cortland, Bobtown. Take your tornado safety precautions immediately downstairs. Underneath something, I need you to get to the center part of the house, and I need you to keep away from windows. That's our initial storm. The other storm right now that's off to the east is bringing damaging winds and possibly a quick tornado to areas like Brewersville and through the north. Storm in North Vernon or in Brewerstown continues to increase here. So we may be seeing an uptick in potential for a quick tornado here. This one you'll notice right to the north of north, or right between North Vernon and the Brewersville area. We need to watch this. That area rotation is coming up a little bit right now. That would increase near Scipio, the possibility of a quick tornado. And also we continue north of Freetown, possibility of a quick tornado. Active night tonight. Really active night where we have a number of storms right now along an outflow boundary that continue to produce possibilities of tornadoes. Remember, what we're trying to do is make everybody happy with golf on one side of the screen, which we'll give you on the left part or right part of your screen, and then on the left side is where we're going to be doing our covering of the storms. You'll notice that from the perspective of the rest of our area, and you know, Louisville's the biggest city within our viewing area, and so when there's something in Louisville, obviously it affects a lot more people. One of the things we also note on our business is that if it affects Louisville, you get less complaints. If it's not affecting Louisville, you get more. And, you know, for what it's worth, I have said for the 15 years I've been here that I don't care if you're in the biggest city in our area or the smallest in our area. We're not going to sacrifice. If there's a threat to life and property, we're going to be there for you. And one of the things I hope that we have proven and we will continue to prove is that we will show by our actions that if you're in the largest or if you're in the smallest county, we're going to make sure if there's a threat to life and property, we're covering you. So in Brewerstown and North Vernon, we need to watch you really closely. Damaging winds possibly coming through, and there's also rotation that has increased a little bit near the Brewerstown area. Hannah, I'm going to come over to your monitor right now, and you're looking again at our analyst computer, and you're looking at the storm in the northern part of Jackson County. And so in Freetown, we continue with that area of rotation that continues to move through.
Well, I want to zoom out just a hair. You can see spinning. I mean, that's the story here. The cell that Mark was just looking at outside North Vernon, there's rest as well. Move just a little bit farther to the west. This is where we were just zoomed in on Freetown, a center of rotation there. But then even as we move a little bit farther to the west, I'm not telling you that this is a tornado. I'm really not. I'm telling you, though, that this is spinning, that we have a lot of cells, a lot of these cells that are moving through along this boundary we've been telling you about all night. They're spinning, and that's going to be the story as we go through the evening. It's clear to see, though, as we walk through each of these little centers of rotation, that this one outside Freetown, that's the spot right now. That's where we're seeing the tightest rotation couplet, likely the strongest center of rotation. You can see the colors there reflecting are just brighter. Mm-hmm. They're more compact. They're tighter together. So that's an area that has our attention right now. In addition to that supercell that Mark was pointing out that's just north northwest of North Vernon right now, there's likely rotation in that as well. I'll show you that here.
Yeah, that one still shows. It's interesting. It shows diffuse rotation, but then near Scipio, you have that rotation increasing just a little bit.
Yes.
So there could be quick spin-ups anywhere across that line, but near the Scipio area is specifically where that rotation has gotten a little bit stronger. National Weather Service just giving us information. They're continuing the tornado warning. Radar indicated this one is for the Jackson and Jennings County until 9:30. Severe thunderstorm capable of producing a tornado was located near Seymour. So this is the time that in Seymour, you've got to be careful. In the northern part of Seymour, between Seymour and Jonesville right now, we need to be really, really cautious. Also, National Weather Service just noting at 9:07, continuing that tornado warning, this one for the Jennings County area. Our northern two counties, Hannah, today really have been the show. I mean, it has been our entire focus during the entire day today. We have not seen anything get further south. While I don't think we're gonna be talking about a tornado threat further south tomorrow, we got to watch on Father's Day damaging wind potential. The fuel tomorrow is going to be outrageous, and this could be something we have to deal with again tomorrow. Just busy stuff, busy couple of days we've got going on here with multiple warnings. Every time, by the way, you hear the beep, that means the National Weather Service has used the word tornado, which means they're using the word tornado nearly nonstop, getting itself organized. That one looks stronger and stronger to me.
I agree.
Both of these look like very solid supercells, and I'm getting more concerned now about the Jennings County storm because there's now a hail core, which means we're probably getting more substantial rising motion. You got to take this one seriously in North Vernon. The storm is intensifying. We've got to watch this one closely. But between North Vernon and Scipio, we've got to watch as this storm continues to show signals that it is intensifying some. It is sitting along a boundary. It is a prime location to get quick spin-ups. And you can see that rotation continues to come up now, right over North Vernon now. We have an area of rotation. And good news on that area of rotation further to the west, that is between Seymour and Jonesville right now, is that area of rotation may have weakened just a touch. So the area of rotation has come down just a little bit. But still over North Vernon, area rotation right now, to me, looks the strongest. We're going to be watching here to make sure that we do not get any signals of debris. The only thing I'm seeing with a debris signal may just be some damaging winds. But over North Vernon right now, an area of rotation, and that area of rotation that's going to go between Jonesville and the Seymour area has weakened in intensity just a touch. Let's do a track on these storms, talk about the most dangerous parts of the storms and where they are going. But you can see, remember when the greens and the reds are next to each other indicates rotation. When the greens and the reds are next to each other and they're really bright, it indicates significant rotation. The rotation's come down just a touch. Doesn't mean the tornado threat's gone, but it's a status update on where that storm is and what it's doing. Bobtown, 2 minutes from now, tornado safety precautions, prepare in Redding, 10 minutes from now, and then in the Redding-Tin area, 14 minutes from now. And then we have that second storm that's further off to the east. So this storm located almost on top of North Vernon. North Vernon being the, a populated area. If you're in North Vernon, or in particular on the north side of North Vernon, take this one pretty seriously, this tornado warning. Rotation has come up just a little bit. It's moving towards Campbell. So 12 minutes from now, it's going to be in the Campbell area. And then in Nebraska, 17 minutes from now. If Nebraska in Jennings County sounds familiar, Nebraska was hit by a tornado a couple of months ago. So Jen have been the hub for activity for us. Our northern counties, it seems like all year long, you could almost say, if there's a severe weather threat, it's going to hit the northern part of our area. Hannah, that line's really been struggling on the west edge, which is a positive here for the Louisville area.
That is certainly a positive. We could have seen a lot more southerly development on the north side of that, on the west side of that. We're certainly not seeing that here. So that's great news for the Louisville area, the more populated kind of center of our viewing area. We do, though, still have plenty of activity showing up right along the northern county lines of our WDRB communities. And so I want to just kind of take the velocity scope and walk through what we're seeing here. Clearly, that rotation center nearly on top of North Vernon, really on the north side of the city. So please, if you're on the north side of the city right now, it's time to be in your safe place as this rotation center moves past you. So as we look a little bit farther to the west, you can see it gets a little bit more muddied. So while we do still have heavy rain, we do still have thunder and lightning on that side of this kind of line of storms, we're not seeing quite the same intensity of rotation, though we will be keeping an eye on it. I do want to mention once more, you can see how it looks a little bit less organized that far west. I do want to mention once more, though, the threat of heavy rain and the potential for life-threatening flash flooding that would come from that. So that cell that's just north of North Vernon right now has a rain rate of 6.25 inches per hour. And again, I'm not telling you the storm is going to sit on top of you for an hour because I don't think that's likely. But think about it. If it's there for 30 minutes, you get more than 3 inches of rain. So if the storm's on top of you for 15 minutes, you're still getting an inch and a half of rain in just that short amount of time. So very real threat of flash flooding here, which can also be a life-threatening situation if you're out in these storms or out shortly after they move past. Mark.
Listen to this report. This one is concerning. From Greensburg, Indiana, a report of a trailer or camper being thrown over a hill with entrapment. Emergency crews are en route to investigate. So that's coming out of Greensburg. It appears that a trailer or a camper was thrown over a hill with an entrapment now. Trees being reported now down and power lines down in Decatur County, Indiana. And Rushville just reported significant damage on the south. I hate reading that stuff. I hate giving you those reports. Unfortunately, there has been quite a bit of damage in the central parts of Indiana from the storms today. For our area, we have yet to get any confirmed reports of damage. I hope it stays that way. To our north, not so much. Rotation continues right over the North Vernon area. Watching that close, and what we have seen from the debris detector is we have not noted anything that we would refer to as a confirmed tornado. But at the same time, what we have seen here is that there is at least some limbs and things that are getting blown from and during the storms. And so that's likely off to the east of North Vernon, whether that's tornado or not. And that's interesting. It looks like there's two primary areas of rotation now, one near Brewersville and one near North Vernon. I'm interested to see, Hannah, when we get an update on radar. So we have two distinct workstations. So Hannah's looking at one workstation. I'm looking at another. That's a lot of rotation right now, very tight rotation near the Brewersville area. And then we have rotation that's off to the west of Campbell. So we're watching these areas both very closely as they are. There's two areas of rotation now, one that's heading towards the Zenas area in Nebraska and one that's going down 50 towards Campbell. If you're in either of these areas, it is time to take your tornado safety precautions. Again, I want to show you that everything here is embedded within rain. So if you're one of those, and I do really understand this. Look, I'm a storm chaser. I understand that sense of trying to see something. But I assure you that if you're looking out there, you will see rain. You will see nothing else. This is embedded in a core of rain. Do not attempt to go outside if you're in Campbellsville or Zena or Nebraska in Jennings County. You will not see anything. And then we've got this area that right now is along 65. So this one right now is near Redding. Again, another area of rotation crossing 65 near Jonesville. This is straddling the county line right now. Jackson County, we're watching as that moves across the county line. Strong winds remain possible. I will say the rotation has weakened just a little bit. That's a positive here, but it's going right near the Bobtown area where we continue to watch that rotate. Tornado watch is still in effect here for Jackson, Jennings, and Lawrence County. It has been canceled for the rest of our area. Tornado watch remains in effect only for our far northern counties. Busy day. If you've lived or if you live in the northern part of Jackson or the northern part of Jennings County, you've been under tornado warnings for hours. We started our Facebook Live coverage. It was probably around 5:30 or 6 today. And we've been talking for almost 3 hours now about the potential for severe weather that's moved through our area. Hannah, I need to ask you a question quickly. Have you built for your show 410? Okay, so you need to start to focus a little bit on making sure that you have your graphics done. So obviously when we have tornado coverage that is this long, what happens is we obviously have a newscast coming up, and we need to talk about what's going to be happening on Father's Day. So Hannah's going to focus on that as I focus on these storms here. So Jonesville right now, area rotation moving across the Redding area. You're watching that really closely. Let me scope inside that storm so you can see. Rotation has come down. I'm glad to say that. I continue to see an area potentially for some 60-mile-an-hour winds, but that rotation is not as significant as it was earlier. I'm going to take you back over to radar here. You'll notice near Redding, there's our area rotation, but I'm going to show you our analyst, which allows us to look at a little bit more closely in that storm. And what that's going to allow me to do is rock back and forward. So as we look, watch the rotation as I take you back a few scans. You're looking north of Kurtz. This was earlier, and you're like, wow, that area rotation, very strong. It was. And you'll notice that the greens and the reds were very close to each other. Watch as I take you into the now. Now you're seeing rotation that's not near as close. You're seeing it's more broad. That potential for a tornado has come down in the Jonesville area and Seymour. It doesn't mean that it won't pulse back up. I'm watching that very closely, but that area of rotation, there's no question, is not as intense as it was earlier. Let's do the same exercise, watching our storm that's near Butlerville. So this one is in Jennings County. And what you'll notice here is the greens and the reds. They are close to each other north of Butlerville, and then we have a secondary area rotation that is just almost on top of Butlerville. Let's do the same exercise. Let's rock this storm. Notice that the reds were more intense. The greens and the reds near the Scipio area were very close to each other, indicating our storm had been stronger. As it's moving now into the eastern part of the county, we're noticing that the rotation maybe coming down just a little bit. Overall, the threat here at some point tonight is going to transition away from this tornado threat and more over towards a damaging wind threat. And that's where I think that we are starting to move in this setup here. More towards potential for some damaging wind. And really, we've got a concern here, a flash flood potential. I would be most concerned about the flood potential in the northern part of Jackson County. On the northern part of Jennings County. That is a real concern as those storms continue their march off towards the east. And speaking about this from the wide perspective about what we have ongoing here, you'll notice that for Louisville, there's not a whole lot ongoing right now. Our storms are still well off to the north. If you're near the E-Town area, no rain, no storms. It is quiet. Let me take you back over to radar here. And you'll notice that the wider perspective here is showing there's not anything in a perspective or trajectory of Louisville. What's going to be our story for tomorrow is you see another one of these clusters of strong to severe storms out to the west. And so what's going to happen with this cluster tomorrow, and this is going to be what Hannah will be talking a lot about in WDRB News at 10, is this cluster is going to move towards us. What will happen is it's probably going to get somewhere near the Ohio River and weaken in the morning. And so as that weakens in the morning, that will lay down a boundary again. So these boundaries are critical. These boundaries act like miniature cold fronts. So imagine now you have a miniature cold front sitting near the Ohio River and we heat up into the upper 80s, mid 80s tomorrow. Here's your problem. The problem becomes then is that heating produces fuel. And you have a mechanism to fire that storms, which would be that leftover boundary, that outflow boundary, the decaying area of thunderstorms from tonight. And that means that we could flare some storms tomorrow. My opinion is tomorrow will need to be also under a severe weather threat. And I think it needs to be under a slight risk of severe weather tomorrow. Reason being, again, I believe that with that boundary decaying and a lot of heating occurring, I believe that is going to be a focus mechanism to generate. Tornado warning remains in effect for parts of the area. 9:30 is our tornado warning for Jackson and Jennings, and then Jennings County through 9:45. So Jennings County till 9:45, Jackson, Jennings County until 9:30. We will watch those storms as they move across our area. Hannah, the intensity of the storms, you know, I have to say the intensity is still there. Mm-hmm. But it does appear that the rotation may be coming down. An encouraging thing as we're moving later into the evening, we don't want to see a tornado any time of the day, but in the night is the worst possible scenario.
Absolutely, especially in this scenario where we're seeing a lot of rain. I mean, it's hard enough to spot a tornado in the daylight when you can see just fine, but it gets even more tricky when they're wrapped in rain and then when you take away the daylight. So we certainly don't want to see this get any worse in the next few minutes. And we do want to remind everybody, we've got golf for you there on the right side of your screen. We're trying to be respectful of the folks that are here to enjoy golf, but we also have a job to do. We're required to pass along life-saving information. That's also just our job, and we want to make sure everybody's safe. And so that's why we're here with you this evening, is to make sure that the folks who are in danger because of these storms, whose lives and whose property are at risk because of these storms, have access to the information that they need to make good decisions and to stay safe this evening. Mark, I heard a lot of alerts come in from the Weather Service. Are those updates of current warnings?
Most of this is status thus far.
Okay.
We also got a flash flood watch, but that one's going to stay north of our area. I can't imagine that with all the waves of rain that we get, that we're not going to need some type of flood watch within our area moving forward as well. I mean, it's just hard to imagine. Just got a report out of Decatur County, Indiana, a report of a tornado, barn down, houses damaged. The 8125 West County Road near 700 South, possible tornado damage. A lot of reports of tornado damage. Significant damage reported in South Rushville with a confirmed tornado. So our friends to the north, Rushville's been hit by a tornado, it appears. Freetown was hit by a tornado, it appears. A number of areas to our north have been hit by storms, impossible tornadoes. You know, my hope is that we can get you, you know, we've tried to show your golf on one side of the screen again. You know, I understand that if it's not affecting me, there is a perception sometimes that it's not happening. I get it, and I get that for you, for your perspective of what's occurring here. From my perspective of somebody that has basically, you know, dedicated my life, I'm 44 years old, to just trying to help and protect property and lives, we can't let this stuff go. The middle ground here we felt today was we would give you golf on one side of the screen. We understand it's a U.S. Open. We understand how important it is. We really, really do. So we've tried to make a compromise here where we can make sure that we get the information out to those need it and those that want to watch golf. You have that opportunity as well. I am watching the northern part of Jackson County. Again, let's do our same. Let's look through our rotation. Let's do the exercise that we have been going through. New radar scan just coming in. So the rotation has come up a little bit between Jonesville and Seymour. Watch the last scan. You can see the greens, the reds, not as bright. They're a little bit brighter and they're a little bit more oriented perpendicular to the beam, the radar beam. It means the rotation has come up just a touch here. Let me look in that storm to see if I'm seeing any debris. Nothing out there right now that would say tornado. And let's do that same exercise as we go east to north, east of North Vernon. So that one's approaching the county line right now, which would mean it would get out of our viewing area. We do cover a viewing area. And so we will say that when the storms leave our viewing area, our responsibility to our viewers within our viewing area, we would then release that. So if the tornado warning expires or moves out of Jennings County, then that would no longer be within our viewing area. But again, we do that same exercise. You can see the reds were brighter near Butlerville, and that one looks like that one is coming down in intensity right now. So that's a positive there, seeing the rotation come down in intensity a little bit near the eastern part of Jennings County, and then our supercell thunderstorm that's near Jonesville continues to be our strongest right now. Let me show you a three-dimensional perspective of what the storms look like. So you can actually see the height of these storms, and these storms are not as tall. Greens peaks up at near around 30,000 feet right here, and then the core of the storm is only around 15,000. So since that one's not as tall, that's the reason we don't have as much hail. And then the storm east of the North Vernon area, so that one peaks up a little bit taller, and you can see as we cut through the core of that storm extending up to around 38,000 feet. That's a vertical look through our storms. Storms continue to pose a threat for damaging winds and isolated tornadoes. National Weather Service, Hannah, you just noted, as far as our tornado warnings are concerned, again, we've gotten a number of reports of tornadoes, Rushville, Freetown, parts of Indiana. Any status on these tornado warnings in the northern part of our area now?
I do have a status update for you. That tornado warning that included Jackson and Jennings counties, so this one that kind of spans both of them, that is going to be allowed to expire at 9:30. That was the 9:30 warning. So within the next couple of minutes, the National Weather Service will allow that one to expire. We are still, though, left with, as we watch these storms, the warning that continues for just Jennings County. And that is valid until 9:45. And again, it's because we still have rotation in these cells that we continue to watch them. I'll tell you, though, I think that this center of rotation is going to move outside of the county here shortly, outside of Jennings County to the east. And so you guys might be able, you might be dropped early from that. You might be trimmed from that. But remember, that warning for Jennings County still valid until 9:45. You can see here the rotation that we're watching outside Butlerville headed toward the Houlton area. And as long as that remains, that leaves the threat for tornadoes. That can drop a tornado at any moment when we see a storm that spins like that. In fact, there's almost too little, there's a little small area of rotation to the north. But again, we're coming up on the county line there. So as Mark mentioned, we do have a coverage area. And so once this storm moves outside of our coverage area, we'll certainly let you know and get you back to golf if that's appropriate at the time. But here we are still watching rotation on the eastern edge of Jennings County.
And so as we stand, I guess, are we good for your...
Yep.
Okay, good.
Be good.
We just have to make
sure...
We got to make sure that we have a newscast at 10. So the tornado warning now, if at 9:45 the tornado warnings are allowed to expire, the first thing we'll do is return you back to programming. Like I said before, we'll say it. We have no desire to stay in here unless there is a threat to life and property. If there is, that's the most important thing. I mean, it just simply is. So here's where we stand right now. Let's talk about the rest of our area. I don't want to hyper focus only on one area. Jasper, no concerns. Louisville, I don't think there's any severe weather risk here tonight. E-Town, Campbellsville, we're quiet. Moving to the north, this is where our line of severe thunderstorms continue with tornado warnings. Here's an interesting one with respect to this, is there's no storms to the south of this, which means that the air that is feeding into these storms remains untouched. That's important. When storms are being fed by untouched air, the fuel's a little higher. Okay, so that means these are going to go all night. Well, no, here's one of the things that's important to note, is that we are starting to cool. It's 9:28, the sun is now set. As the sun sets, the fuel is going to get more poor. As that happens, these storms will weaken in intensity. They are showing that signal right now that they may not be the storms that they once were. But that said, we still have tornado warnings in effect for parts of the area. Let me do a scope as we move through the storms. The one storm that was originally the Jennings County storm is out of county. So that one is now moving towards Johnson. Tornado threat from that one is lowering. However, that said, we still have the western area, and that area of rotation has come up. And so that means for North Jennings, you have another threat of a possible tornado moving through. With that moving off to the east at around 30 miles an hour, that means that area of rotation will also go across your area. We've been doing this coverage for a couple of hours, probably one of the longest we have done this year. So North Vernon, in 16 minutes from now, you need to prepare. There's another storm that's coming through. It could possibly drop a tornado. Right now, we're not seeing signals of any debris, which would take us from tornado warning. Only one tornado warning. This is going to be interesting. And Hannah, I'm going to ask the Weather Service about this because the area of rotation on that initial warning has now moved out of county.
Yep.
And so...
But if we look, watch as I bring this scope back, that's not the only area of rotation. I mean, we've told you all night, this stuff is spinning like a top as this boundary kind of sets up right through here. So we can see very clearly right here that the area of rotation that initially earned a warning, I'll circle it right here, that has moved out of Jennings County now, which is what I was just telling you about. I think that this is going to move outside the county. And look, there you go. The Weather Service has issued a severe thunderstorm warning as this cell moves outside of Jennings County. So we are awaiting their advice on what they're going to do with the tornado warning. You can still see there's a cell in the area in Jennings County, another spot of particularly heavy rain headed toward North Vernon. And as we put the velocity scope on that, I'd argue there's still a little bit of rotation moving
I think you could go either way at this point now.
I agree. Frankly, I agree with their severe thunderstorm warning decision. Yeah. We just need to see what they decide to do with this tornado warning. Still a threat as far as rotation goes. Everything is spinning this afternoon.
And what they're going to do is they're going to stay with the tornado warning for the same reason that you and I kind of talked about, is that second storm with some rotation is moving into that warning area. It is kind of confusing because the initial storm that prompted that warning has left the warning area. But again, with a second area moving in, their sense right now is let's stay tornado warning, rather than issue a separate one. You know, the positive here in doing it this route is that we don't have to get a second warning that you would cancel and then reissue, which can get very confusing. But that area rotation, technically speaking, is not within the warning. The area rotation is about 3 miles west of that warning, but within the next 6 minutes, we'll be into the warning area. I think that what we should do probably here moving forward is going to be severe thunderstorm warning with tornado possible. National Weather Service, for what it's worth, just did a status on that tornado warning out of Jennings County, and they're saying tornado capable of producing a tornado was located near North Vernon. And so this one's now picking up speed a little bit, moving east at 40 versus the room right now is going to go just off to the north of the North Vernon area. If you live in North Vernon, I know that you've been under a tornado warning for a while. I know it can be tiring. I know it can really fatigue. I know it's tough to take your family into the safe spot and then get out of the safe spot and then go back into the safe spot. But remember, there's still an area rotation. It is worth it. It is worth taking your tornado safety precautions in North Vernon right now. Which, remember, use the word duck. It's easy to remember. If something bad is coming towards you, duck. Well, duck has a meaning. It means downstairs. It means underneath something. It means the center part of your house. And it means keep away from windows. And please do that. Take your tornado safety precautions if you're in the North Vernon area. A secondary area of rotation is coming through in about 15 to 20 minutes from now. It'll have passed your area. My hope is it'll have passed your area without doing any damage, and we'll see that rotation coming down. But North Vernon has been under the gun several times today. This is not our normal scenario for our area. Quite frankly, we normally don't get tornado warnings on separate storms that repeatedly go over the exact same area. But today's not that. Somebody asked me on social today and said, Mark, did you guys expect any severe weather with possibility of tornadoes? And the answer was yes. If you watched me last night, you noticed that I had within our viewing area the possibility of a quick spin up. And I even showed the tornado symbol. And the reason here that we felt like this is because what we have is called a mesoscale convective vortex. In layman terms, what that is a mid-level low that's generated by prior day storms. And what that can do is that can enhance the wind energy. And that is exactly what has happened here. The only tornado warning that remains in effect for our area is for Jennings County right now. But that said, if you're in North Vernon, you've got to take it very seriously and use some caution. There's an area of rotation moving across your area. That storm has shown at least that it's thrown maybe some leaves up. That could just be from straight line winds. But Hannah, we are watching that. You have watched that on our 3D radar. The advantage of this is some different colors within the pink there. What the pink in this situation would indicate if you're in the storm, it's all rain.
Yeah, it's all rain. So then we're looking for something that's not pink. We're looking for something on this particular product that is different. And that's what you see pointed out here. Just a couple of small areas that are yellow or orangish. And as I flip back over to where the velocity is, where that rotation couplet is, they don't line up quite perfectly. So we're not telling you that this is debris lofted by a tornado because they don't line up quite right. And in fact, I'll flip over to the reflectivity. It does meet that qualification. So we do have this lowering of CC in the high reflectivity value. But again, it doesn't necessarily line up real well with the rotation couplet. So not a guarantee, far from it, that there's a tornado on the ground here. But certainly the storm is rotating, and it is likely putting some leaves in the air, some right. small twigs or something like that. So nothing too large at this point, I would say.
You know, I would argue at this point we should move over to severe thunderstorm with tornado possible tags. I got to say that the rotation continues. It's there. It's 100% that there is still rotation within these storms. But the actual intensity, velocity of that rotation has notably come down over the last hour. And, you know, unfortunately, we have to wait for the Weather Service if they're going to decide to stay tornado warning or go severe thunderstorm. But I just feel like, yes, there is rotation. But when we're looking at rotation, and remember, that's in an area where the radar beams about 4,000 feet above the ground. And it's about 40 miles an hour. That normally means that your threat is, it could have some mid-level rotation, but straight line winds are going to be the primary threat here.
Well, it's interesting just to watch this loop through. I'm going backward two scans here, and in this picture that you're seeing in this image, the rotation is stronger outside Jonesville, but even that North Vernon storm that we were watching, that looks more powerful. So we go forward two scans, and it's like a completely different system. We still see good rotation now just to the northwest of North Vernon, but the storm that just exited Jennings County, that rotation's not looking great. Again, it's getting much farther away from the radar, so that's a factor to consider. I think shows the nature of the atmosphere at this point that we are seeing a little bit of a downward trend. Yeah. Not over, certainly not over by any stretch of the imagination, but seeing a little bit of a downward trend in terms of these spinning cells, these rotating cells.
And by the way, I just messaged the Weather Service. For what it's worth, like I said, my opinion right now is that that we should go severe thunderstorm warning with a tornado possible. I do want to mention here, and I apologize, I'll let the guys in the production know that it's probably going to be a quick black flash, so I apologize for that. But we now have flash flood warnings for the northern part of our area. So Jackson and Jennings County, you are now under a flash flood warning. So look, we have talked about that this was going to become a problem. This rain continues over the exact same area. You're not talking about rain that's like little, maybe an inch. You're talking about rain that's coming down at an obscene rate. And when you have that volume of rain coming down that continues to strike over the same area, that creates a distinct problem here. Again, I apologize, going back over to radar here to get you that image of where the rain continues to move across our area. But rain continues to strike the same areas, and that then creates this problem. So you can see there, this is a legitimate threat of flash flooding in the north part of Jennings County. This is a lot of rain that has fallen over a short period of time. And I'm kind of curious in this particular show, if we've got radar totals, but the storm totals here have got to be over 2 inches in parts of these area. Rain rates are just unbelievable and continue to be absolutely crazy. So just north of North Vernon, your rainfall rate is 4.85 inches per hour. Obviously, it's not going to rain for that entire time, but it's a lot of rain that will continue to fall, and so this creates that threat. Hannah, I'm going to come back over to 3D real quickly. Weather Service said they're going to make the decision in the next couple of moments on that storm, but you assume that your opinion is going to be the same as mine. It looks like it's tanking.
It does look like it's tanking, and fast. Here's the thing. We've been watching these storms for hours. I think you know that at this point. And everything trends down slowly, and then maybe would cycle back up or just kind of dissipates, but it does not happen this quickly. Within just the space of two scans here, you can really watch this rotation center tank. So again, it is our responsibility. We're obligated to stay with this warning as long as the Weather Service feels that there's a threat to life here, and that's what the nature of a tornado warning means. And so we're going to stay with you until that threat is over. And I think in the next couple of minutes, we're going to be able to say that it is. We're certainly seeing this trending downward. I'm not telling you it's completely over yet, but we are seeing a downward trend in this rotation. So again, we'll cycle back through the last two scans and go back to the current scan. And you can really just see the colors are not as bright.
Right.
The couplet is not as tight. We're not seeing that quite as close together anymore. So yes, I am of the opinion we've got 5 more minutes on this warning, right. This particular warning, so that the Weather Service has 5 minutes to make a decision of what they're going to do here.
And they just expired the tornado warning here. So as we stand right now, it's 9:40. We have no tornado warnings left in effect for our area. A severe thunderstorm warning remains off to the east. We've got flash flood warnings now for Jackson and Jennings County, and we promised you the second that our tornado warnings were allowed to expire, we would return you to programming. At 9:41, all of our tornado warnings have been allowed to expire. We'll continue to monitor things. Remember, Hannah will have an update on WDRB News at 10. If golf is still on, we will be on WBKI. Keep it right here for continuing weather updates.